The politically charged battle over climate change is increasingly spreading to the classroom. At issue, how and whether to teach it, including the scientific consensus about the role of human activity. It's a debate playing out in states adopting new science standards, including in Idaho, where a key vote could come this week. Special correspondent Lisa Stark of our partner Education Week reports from Boise. It's for our weekly segment, Making the Grade.
What's clay?
Earth!
These Boise second graders are playing an unusual game of tag.
On your marks, get set, go!
They're pretending to be sunlight. Once they reach Earth, they turn into heat. Some bounce back. Others are tagged and trapped by students masquerading as greenhouse gases.
Look at that! All right!
The idea is to help students understand global warming.
So the more greenhouse gases we add to the atmosphere, what happens to the temperature of the Earth? Yes.
It gets hotter.
It gets hotter.
What is climate change? What did you learn about that when you were outside playing tag?
It's when people put more carbon dioxide in the air and it makes it warmer.
Boise State University professor Jennifer Pierce offers this lesson on climate change to elementary school classes.
I think it's my obligation as a scientist and as an educator and as a parent to teach our kids about how the greenhouse effect works, how humans and fossil fuels have contributed to the warming of our planet, and what we can do about it.
Pierce crafted these lessons after becoming alarmed when Idaho's Republican-dominated legislature moved to soften proposed state science standards to play down the role of humans in climate change.
Well, the legislators seem to think that, you know, you need to present both sides of the issue, that you need to be even-handed.
There aren't two sides of the issue. The global warming is happening and humans are the cause. There's not another side of the issue.
We'd like to call the House Education Committee to order.
The fight over new Idaho science standards for grades kindergarten through 12 has now dragged on for 3 years.
You were on the committee that drafted these standards and redrafted these standards and redrafted these standards.
Yes.
What was the problem?
Melissa Farrow, an award-winning Idaho science teacher, believes lawmakers have tried to dismantle the group's hard work for political showmanship.
The big concern here is people think we're trying to sneak something by them. We're trying to indoctrinate the children of Idaho into concepts that go against the moral or religious beliefs of the citizens. But I would argue that the science is sound in these standards.
Last year, lawmakers temporarily approved the standards, but removed 5 sections on climate change, including one that emphasized, quote, the major role that human activities play in causing the rise in global temperatures. Lawmakers asked for a rewrite. Representative Ryan Kirby supported that, saying students were being force-fed one-sided arguments.
They just said, man has XYZ impact on the environment, or these things are bad, versus saying, hey, students, look at the data, do some research, and let's talk about the good things and the bad things that man do to the environment.
The public has overwhelmingly disagreed.
Science education shouldn't be a political issue.
Not some watered-down, censored version.
I ask that we not only keep the standards, but that we accept and appreciate all that they have to offer.
That did not sway the Idaho House Education Committee, which this month voted again, this time deleting one science standard that linked air pollution with fossil fuels and scrapping pages and pages of content that backed up every area of science instruction, including global warming.
The motion passes. Thank you.
Representative Scott Syme led the charge, saying he was deleting sections that didn't allow students to do their own scientific discovery.
When you have conclusions and standards, it stifles inquiry. What we're going to see is we're going to be developing scientists, kids that can think on their own, that come to their own conclusions.
Syme refused repeated requests for an interview, but told a newspaper, quote, I don't care if students come up with a conclusion that the Earth is flat, as long as it's their conclusion, not something that's told to them.
The debate over teaching climate change is hardly limited to Idaho. There have been a number of states, as they have been revising their science standards, where this has become a hot-button issue.
New Mexico's attempt last fall to weaken climate change instruction generated protests and fierce backlash.
The children, the future of New Mexico, deserve better.
Ultimately, the State Department of Education backed down. Recent attempts in at least 9 states to block, repeal, or modify state science standards, partly because of the treatment of climate change, have largely failed. All this comes during a government administration skeptical about global warming.
The United States will withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord.
In the case of climate change, of course, there have been many really concerted efforts to kind of deny the science.
David Evans is the executive director of the National Science Teachers Association.
When a legislative body decides to recommend against science content that's been well vetted by the science community and the education community, we undergo a great risk at denying our children really important information that they're going to need.
Each of these has a type of resource on it. See if you can decide whether it's renewable or non-renewable.
The Boise School District isn't waiting for the state to act. There's local control of education in Idaho, and this district is teaching climate science.
I know that global warming, even if it's not caused by humans, it's at least happening with, like, our Earth is warming up slowly.
I don't, like, genuinely think of, oh yeah, climate change and global warming, like, yeah, I could change that, I could do that. Like, I feel like that's something that everyone will have to come to, not just one person.
Science teacher Nathan Dean says in more rural, conservative parts of Idaho, global warming will only be taught if it's required by the state.
I feel like we'd be really remiss to say that we're preparing kids in science education and science literacy if they aren't aware of global warming and climate change and the science behind that.
Dean bristles at what's been happening in the state legislature.
I think that it would be kind of educational malpractice to pretend that there's two sides to that scientific argument.
Representative Kirby says he's not opposed to teaching global warming, as long as kids figure out the causes based on their own research.
We really want the students to protect our environment, to protect our planet, but we want them thinking, not being spoon-fed.
Tractor that has a solar panel on it.
Back in that second grade Boise classroom, students are figuring out ways to help protect the environment.
If you want to go to the zoo, you don't need to drive. You could like bike there. It's basically a cooling vest. So like whenever it's too hot, you can put on the cooling vest.
So far, though, there's no indication anyone is cooling off in Idaho. It's now up to the Senate Education Committee to decide whether to go along with their House colleagues or leave the science standards intact. The vote is expected as early as this week. For the PBS NewsHour and Education Week, I'm Lisa Stark in Boise, Idaho.